I think we all know by now that sugar is not good for us, and we're trying to cut it down, if not cut it out. But we don't always know what it is. We know it's that white crystal that we shouldn't be sprinkling on our food. But where else is sugar? Where are all the hidden sugars? How do we get through all this minefield of terminology around sugars and starches and simple starches and complex ones and complex carbohydrates and simple carbohydrates? What is all that about? I'm going to explain that to you today. This video is not about what sugar does. We've got other videos for that. This is just a basic chemistry lesson, what sugar actually is and how to know it when you see it. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew Tunstall. I'm a nutritionist. I am a lifestyle coach and I am a science geek. That's right. I'm a nerd. I used to be a science teacher and I have been playing with my kids' toys. So look what I made. This is nerdy. I made this with my kids' chemistry set. And this is a model of a molecule of glucose. Okay, a very basic sugar molecule. And this is blood sugar. When you measure your blood sugar, you're counting these. And it goes through your blood into your cells where it is processed so that you can and produces energy. Now, there are three types of sugars that look very similar. There's this one, glucose. There's this one that looks almost the same, except you see, so it's also a ring, and you see this looks like an animal with a head. Okay, this head here, on the glucose it points down. That's the only difference, and this is called galactose. And galactose cannot be processed in your cells. Okay, they're almost the same, but your body can tell the difference. When you get galactose in your food, it first goes to the liver. It is turned into glucose. Once it's been rebuilt in the form of glucose, then it goes to your cells. But they're both simple sugars. And the third one is one you have heard of, fructose, sometimes called fruit sugar. So that's a fructose molecule. Now, it's not that dissimilar. It's also a ring in the middle. It's a slightly smaller ring. And fructose, your body has the same problem as it does with galactose. You can't use fructose for energy. You can only use glucose. So the fructose also needs to go to the liver, be converted, so broken down, rebuilt in this form, and then it goes to your body. Now these three sugars all have exactly the same number of carbon atoms, those are the black ones, oxygen atoms, and hydrogen atoms, all exactly the same, so they actually all have the same chemical formula. And if you were a nerd, you'll know it's C6H12O6. Don't worry about that. Right, so these three simple sugars are the three types of sugar that you can find in your food. Sometimes they will join together. So if you have a glucose molecule and a fructose molecule, and you link them together in a sort of double, that is called sucrose or table sugar. There you have it. So when you eat table sugar, the first thing that has to happen in your body is they have to be broken apart. Okay, so this little chain has to be broken. Now what happens? The glucose goes into your blood and off to your cells, the fructose to the liver, turned into glucose, and then off to the cells. Simple as. If you combine glucose with galactose, you get lactose or milk sugar. So this is what you get when you have dairy products. Same problem. First of all, it has to be split. Glucose goes to your cells, galactose, liver, turned into glucose, off to the cells. All a simple process. But these are called simple sugars or simple carbohydrates. When they're joined together in two, they're still called simple carbohydrates because they're not that complicated. But you can have longer. You can join three together or four or 100. So when it's three or more, suddenly takes on a whole new name, complex carbohydrate. So what's the difference? Well, it's a longer chain. So you might have 10 glucose molecules in a chain. So this is a kind of starch because that's what starch is. It's just a long chain of sugar molecules. Goes into your body, has to be picked apart, bang, stomach full of sugar, off it all goes into your bloodstream. So whether you have a simple carbohydrate or a complex carbohydrate, which is three or more, you're just eating sugar. It's the same thing. It's just sugar. Now, people will try and tell you, because there are vested interests, there's a big food industry with a lot of money at stake, and they will try and tell you that a complex carbohydrate is good for you and a simple carbohydrate is bad for you. Trouble is, that complex carbohydrate, which is a chain of these things, the first thing that happens when it gets inside you is it splits up into simple carbohydrates. So how is that suddenly good for you? It's nonsense. It takes a little longer to digest because you first have to break the chains. But once you've broken the chains, it's sugar. Nonetheless, it's exactly the same thing. It's still sugar. Ah, but I hear you say, I'm eating whole wheat bread. It has fiber in it. It has extra vitamin B1 in it. It has all sorts of wonderful things in it. Maybe, maybe true. But do you really have to eat all that sugar to get your vitamin B1? I don't think so. If I took a glass of Coke, sugary Coke, and I dropped a dissolvable vitamin C tablet into the Coke, does that make it a health drink? Nah, I thought not. So, there you go. Please share this video with the next person who tells you that a complex carbohydrate is somehow different from just a bowl full of sugar. A bowl full of pasta is a bowl full of sugar. It's a big sugar bomb waiting to go off in your system after you've eaten it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for sharing this. And if anybody argues with you, just point them to this video. This is just Chemistry 101. That's all it is. It's got nothing to do with opinion. It's got nothing to do with what you like eating. It's got nothing to do with the marketing nonsense. It is just basic chemistry. Thank you so much for your time.